Well, let's pick up our story of the play right at the start of the first Old Firm meeting of the season on what was a perfect day for football. Perfect conditions, two teams very evenly balanced, both starting the season impressively. The commentator is Jock Brown.
And that's as follows: Bonner, Sneddon, McGrain, Aiken, McAdam, McLeod, Provan, Sullivan, McGarvey, Burns and McCluskey. With the substitutes today, Roddy McDonald and Charlie Nicholas. On the Rangers side is Peter McCloy, Jordan, Miller, Forsyth, Jackson and Bett, Johnston, Russell, McAdam, Redford and McDonald, with the substitutes Davy Cooper and Derek Johnston. And there's Tom McAdam, one half of the brothers making footballing history this afternoon, lining up against his brother Colin in the Rangers side to become the first brothers to oppose each other directly in an Old Firm match. Tom signed from Dundee United and Colin, of course, from Partick Thistle. And the referee for this afternoon's match, the highly experienced Eddie Pringle of Edinburgh. So Frank McGarvey and George McCluskey get the first Old Firm match of the 1980-81 season underway. Here's Burns making progress up the Celtic left, but the free kick awarded, and that's McGrain. Forsyth getting to that one before McGarvey. McAdam winning that tussle with McGrain. Here's Russell. McAdam on the Rangers right, facing his brother for the first time. McGrain steps in, now it's taken. McGarvey's little flick, but that's Jackson. McGrain leaping very high indeed over John McDonald. Bobby Russell for Rangers. And taken there before McDonald. McCluskey just trying to put it in the path of Roy Aiken. Jim Bett trying to calm things down for Rangers. That's Miller's long ball aimed for John McDonald. And that's Bonner outside his area, surely. Yes, the linesman on the near side has his flag raised, and the free kick to Rangers in a very dangerous position. Pat Bonner directing the wall, and Rangers may well have a rehearsed move for this free kick. Willie Johnston's there, Ian Redford. And Colin McAdam also. Straight into the wall by McAdam. Johnston trying to find room to run. That's an indirect free kick. Alan Sneddon's unhappy, but the referee considers that was obstruction. So the pressure remains on the Celtic goal mouth. Jackson going into the box. Once again, Willie Johnston with the dead ball. The same for Jackson, but there's McAdam. Can't quite keep the ball in play. Big smile from Colin McAdam. A goal kick to Celtic. Plusky and Forsyth. Ball goes to Celtic. It's Burns to McGarvey. It's a good turn by McGarvey. And again, he's gets that ball to the near post. Mother McLeod's in quickly, but cleared very well by the Rangers defence. Danger's not yet over though. That's Provan fighting very hard. Kicks the ball from Redford. That's Miller conceding the corner kick to Celtic. So 10 minutes of the first half gone. Celtic's first corner kick. Tom McAdam going into the Rangers penalty area. Robin takes the kick. McAdam's coming for it. And that's off the post. That's an orthodox corner kick by Davy Provan. Peter McCloy misjudges the flight of the ball. He's all at sea. And Tom McAdam will never come closer to scoring. Headed with that header. Russell and McGrain. McGrain wins it. Russell coming back very quickly to challenge Burns. Redford coming clear. That's space for John McDonald now. Lovely dummy by Russell. That's a fine effort by Jim Bett. A very crisp effort indeed from Bett. Perhaps a bit ambitious from fully 25 yards. But some good build-up play by Rangers. Redford looking for Johnston, but that's Sneddon. And there's a break from McGarvey. Bett trying to go back quickly. McGarvey needs support. And the Rangers defence now back in numbers. McLeod to McCluskey. That's a fine effort. George McCluskey coming very close to goal number one for Celtic. And that started from the break from McGarvey. He had to wait for support. McLeod eventually reached George McCluskey. And McCloy cutting down the angle for McCluskey. Made the target too small. Sandy Job. That's McAdam getting to that one before Russell. McGarvey controlling it for McGrain. Now Burns with Bett and Jackson in attendance. McCluskey. Now McLeod. Bett is over very quickly indeed with the tackle, but the challenge is unfair, says the referee. A free kick, almost 30 yards out, but a chance for a rehearsed move from the Celtic camp. Garvey's there, Provan's there, now it's Sullivan. Back to McLeod. And that's just touched wide of the post by McCloy. The little free kick from Provan. And that drive from Murdo McLeod. What a magnificent save from Peter McCloy. Now it's Provan with the corner. Towards the near post. It's won by Forsyth. Back in by Aiken. And that's McCloy. Sharp looking for McDonald. That's a free kick to Rangers. McGrain just a fraction late. Now it's Bett. Back across the Rangers defence once again. John McDonald. Scythe looking for Redford. And that's a great tackle by McGrain. Now some space. McLeod looking for McGrain. That's Russell in quickly. McGrain showing great strength indeed. And McAdam showing fine control. Now Jordan. John McDonald. Same for McAdam. Oh, magnificent effort by Colin McAdam. A tremendous hitch kick on the turn. Now George McCluskey. He gets past Forsyth. Here's a chance for Burns. And he really should have done much better than that. The break by McCluskey in the far side, escaping Tom Forsyth. He picked out Tommy Burns with the cutback, but on the less strong right foot, Burns loses control of the shot. Alan Snedden.
Here, danger for Scotland. Brilliant clearance there. Danger still not over. Well, Gary Caldwell can take a bow because that was fantastic defending. Still some work to be done though. Well, Scotland had cleared the danger and then gave the ball away, and they'll have to survive a corner. But Gary Caldwell with a magnificent piece of defending, heading off his own goal line.
Again, into a danger area. Great header away from Russell Anderson. But Gary Caldwell, we don't see it in the rerun. Gary Caldwell, wonderful defender. Throws yourself into the net at it too, but you have to do that at times when you're defending, and it was brilliant stuff.
Well, it must have been close to being over the line there. I'm sure our Japanese hosts will give us a rerun of that any moment now as the flag goes up for offside. And, well, guess what? Martin Petrov isn't happy. I think the scowl he's had for most of this game, he's been frustrated.
That's the side of his game that I don't particularly like.
Here we go, Derek, let's have a look at this. It was terrific quick delivery from the free kick, and a couple of ricochets and a couple of bounces, and in the end some terrific defending from Caldwell.
Yeah, I think he would just have managed. It was just not a great angle but there, but how he digs that out is brilliant from the header. That's great defending.
Well, really good play from Topu Zakhov as well, the defender who'd curled it in towards goal. And up the other end, Scotland have done well to get themselves a free kick here. This is McFadden territory. It was McCulloch who was in there, and he's just being gently helped to his feet by Angelov, and he's won his country a free kick in a very, very promising position indeed. How Scotland would love another goal now, 16 minutes into the second half. And McFadden, you can see he fancies this already. Referee's just telling him wait for the whistle.
Well, we've seen him score from that left foot, this distance, Kennedy, before, and just like hope he hits, make sure he hits the target, make the keeper make a save first and foremost.
Mr. Kamikawa just making sure that the wall's back the requisite 10 yards, and it's James McFadden against Stoyan Kolev in goal. McFadden's effort is fantastic. How unlucky is that from James McFadden? Beautiful delivery from the Everton man. Keeper knew absolutely nothing about it. Only the woodwork denies James McFadden and Scotland a third goal.
Yeah, it was an opportunity, wasn't it? I think as you can see the disappointment in James's face there. This is brilliant. Great technique. Keeper's nowhere near that.
He must have thought that was in all the way.
We did here because the keeper was lost. There's no chance of that.
Wonderful technique from James McFadden. Goalkeeper nowhere near it, and but for the crossbar, Scotland would almost be home and hosed in this game, and they might just be just now. McCulloch giving chase. Goalkeeper Kolev just about clears the danger for Bulgaria. Well, I wonder if Scotland can draw further inspiration from that wonderful free kick from the man that's on the ball just now, James McFadden, clearly in the mood, the former Motherwell man. And Gary Naismith now taking his lead. Naismith to Severin. Severin's played well in this game. That's another nice pass from him. Terrific stuff from Scotland here. Fletcher. Decent from Fletcher to Severin. Well, really nice football from Scotland. Scott Severin was at the heart of everything there. Patient build-up, and when the ball came back to him, decent contact, good technique, and just too close to the goalkeeper.
Yeah, I think it was a decent ball. Everybody expects Fletcher to put the cross into the back post, and they seem to cut it back a bit, and Severin just didn't make the best of contacts on it, but it was some good play from Scotland, and you know, this has been good to see this evening.
Scotland's putting on a really good show here in the Kobe Wing Stadium. And Bulgaria trying to do something with their substitute, Yanev. And Scotland will come away again if McFadden can get there. He does well. And a chance for Scotland here on the break. We've got a couple of men over. Teal's there, and so's Fletcher. It was McFadden's pass. And Fletcher has plenty of space because Lucio Wagner had backed off him. Gary Teal's delivery is poor, I have to say. And the pressure is all off Bulgaria, and that's unfortunate. That was promising for Scotland. And we'll have to watch out here because Petrov's away. Terrific pace from the Bulgarian captain. Nice pass as well. The substitute's ball is just a little bit too far for Todorov. Well, he knows it as well. Pistol Yanev curled in a last-minute free kick to defeat the Japanese a couple of days ago in the Nagai Stadium in Osaka. And that wasn't quite up to scratch from Pistol Yanev, the CSKA Sofia midfielder. But he's looked lively. Petrov always looks lively. So there's still some life in the Bulgarians yet. Scotland will have to be wary as they protect this 2-1 advantage. To the closing 25 minutes here in Kobe. Fletcher, Caldwell. I have no idea who he was trying to pass to there, Derek. Do you?
I think it was looking for James McFadden to run into the channel. James acknowledged that he checked his run and went the other way. And that was the reason why he played into that empty space.
Scotland won't want to gift that kind of easy possession to the Bulgarians. Having said that, Bulgaria do exactly the same thing for Scotland. Now then, Gary Teal, I fancy a little stroll up the touchline here. Still it's Teal. Gary Naismith available. Oh, just a little bit too strong for the fullback. He'd made a lung-bursting run as well. He'll be disappointed he couldn't get on the end of Teal's delivery.
Yeah, I think Gary Teal, good vision. He's seen him at the back post. Naismith coming in. A couple of inches bigger, he might have got a hold of it, get his head onto that one, but Gary Teal did chase it before. Great vision to see him running into the back, and good running from Naismith as well, good support.
It's been worth the trip for these Scotland fans. Several hundred are here inside the Kobe Wing Stadium, and they've watched some nice football from their team, and we've seen two goals from Chris Boyd on his Scotland debut. What a story that is. The story isn't quite finished yet though.
Exactly, Carolina, so we've got to remember, being very cautious for Scotland, remember, so this is going well at the moment, that could all change. I hope not, because the boys have done well tonight.
I'll try my best not to get too carried away. Bulgaria 1, Scotland 2, and it's Bulgaria trying to fashion something from long range. Well, Alexander has been on top of everything, and Angelov, he's had an impressive game for Bulgaria from midfield. 28-year-old Levski Sofia player. It's only his second cap, but he's looked the part, doesn't look out of place at all on the international stage, nor do any of these Scotland players, especially not this man here, Fletcher. Murty to Gary Teal, he just couldn't quite beat the defender, and that's disappointing from Gary Teal. Another Scotland attack breaks down, and another Bulgarian one starts. Don't see too much of Domovkiski on the ball. This man, Pistol Yanev, has been involved a lot since he came on. His captain is at the centre of everything. To Todorov, to Yanev, that's ambitious, and bounces awkwardly in front of Alexander, but as I've said so many times before in this game, Neil Alexander has done everything that was asked of him, and that was, you know, an ambitious effort, but you can see that Pistol Yanev, he really fancied it, Derek.
Yeah, he fancied it himself from that distance. I thought it was a bit ambitious myself. The ball went up just in front of Alexander, but I think he's overall tonight he's been quite comfortable with the shots he had. I'm just looking at the way they're playing. Obviously they try and get Petrov on the ball as much as they can, but Scotland are doing the same, trying to get Fletcher on the ball, because for me Fletcher's been the standout of the evening. His range of passing at times is brilliant.
Teal's touch for Murty with a good ball back to the feet of Gary Teal. Good pace from Teal. Can he deliver? He can, towards McFadden. What a goal that is! James McFadden for Scotland. A wonderful piece of football. Murty and Teal involved. Perfect delivery from Teal. Perfect finish, you have to say, for James McFadden. You see the scoreline there. Happy days for the Tartan Army. Bulgaria 1, Scotland 3. And James McFadden, the substitute, has his ninth goal from his country. Walter Smith must be absolutely delighted.
Yeah, he'll be chuffed with that. Great player. Positive. It's been all night like that, hasn't it? Teal very positive, just getting to the byline, puts the ball in. You can see James McFadden, as every good forward does, just tries and gets in front of his defender and attacking that near post, and that's good play. I mean, week in, week out, guys are coached here doing that, and that's great. Just next in front there, great finish.
Terrific stuff from James McFadden and from Gary Teal. It was an immaculate piece of football from Scotland. And, well, can you quite believe it? Bulgaria 1, Scotland 3, 24 minutes played in this second half.
Gavin Reid just come on there, Kennedy.
There we have it. While the replays of that wonderful McFadden goal were happening, Gavin Reid came on and Scott Severin departed. So Gavin Reid's rehabilitation continues, back from serious injury. Gavin Reid, he played 8 games towards the end of the season for Rangers, and he's now on for his 10th cap for Scotland. And he'll be absolutely delighted to get involved in this entertaining and so far terrific Scotland performance here in the Kobe Wing Stadium. Bulgaria 1, Scotland 3, 2 from Chris Boyd. A double on his Scotland debut. And James McFadden adding to that. And are there more goals in this game for Scotland yet? Lovely touch from McFadden to McCulloch. Teal wants it played in front of him to the space there. Lee McCulloch will go for goal. Wasn't the best of shots, cannoned off the defender. Would have been better, I think, playing into Teal. And Scotland will hope that Bulgaria won't profit here. And so they'll drag over from the substitute there, Risto Janev. But his delivery hasn't been the best. Scotland will be thankful for that. And Gary Teal can set up that McFadden goal. On the ball once again, and Fletcher will give Gavin Reid his first touch. Reid on to Naismith. Scotland, understandably, in absolutely no hurry because they have a two-goal cushion, and they'll be quite happy just to stroke the ball about. Murty sees the run of James McFadden. McFadden holds on to it. There's two Bulgarian players there. McFadden almost gets the better of them. He fouls Lucio Wagner. And you can tell that McFadden's really in the mood this evening, Derek, can you?
Yeah, I think he's, I like the way James McFadden plays. People say he's a bit fiery, but I think if you took that out of his game, he'd be a completely different player. And I like that in the player.
Bulgaria will make another substitution. Georgi Ilyev coming on for Domovkiski. So, and substitution from the goalkeeper as well, Stoyan Kolev coming on, and 17-year-old Nikolai Mikhailov will take over in goals. And Genkov coming on for Todorov as well. So the manager, Stoichkov, putting all his cards on the table now. And Bulgaria will simply be going for broke, and Stoichkov won't be enjoying this.
No, I don't think a guy like him would like to lose the match, but I think it's perhaps an opportunity to bring some new players and get people caps and stuff, and get them involved. Perhaps a bit of an experiment for them.
Danger here for Scotland. Can Bulgaria fashion something? Early touch for Ilyev. Crunching tackle coming in from Caldwell, but a fair one on Kelkiski, according to the referee, and he doesn't fancy it too much. The referee wasn't too impressed, but
I don't think it'll be too long, Kennedy, before he's up on his feet.
Perhaps I wonder how much of the ball Caldwell actually got there.
Probably perhaps a clash of knees, I think it is there. It's just a dead leg just above the knee. I think he got his feet shot.
Kelkiski has had a pretty good game for Bulgaria in the heart of their midfield. It's his fourth cap for his country. And then another Levski Sofia player, of which there were 5 in the starting lineup for Bulgaria. And it's no wonder they're celebrating.
Well, they should, because they don't get often to do it, so it's nice to see that, obviously. It amazed me, the Tatman, you know, the amount of money they spend and the time to get here as well. Other side of the world, and they come and still support the team. They're absolutely brilliant.
We're about to see Chris Burke coming on to get his first cap for Scotland. The Rangers winger just warming up, out of your shot there. And Murty just taking a breather. And off will come Gary Teal, and it'll be a like for like swap. Gary Teal coming off, and Chris Burke will just slot into his familiar right wing position.
Yeah, I think Chris Burke's had a wonderful season for Rangers. Great wee player, and I think it's good to see Gary Teal. I think he deserves his chances now to play, because he's had a good season at Wigan as well. And it's a good time to go when you're 3-1 up. You've just got to want to go on the ball as much as you can. He's a confidence player, Lee Burke, and I just hope that he gets on the ball as quick as he can.
On his shots for his first cap for his country. And Chris Burke with an influence in these last 15 minutes, in the same way that James McFadden has had an influence since he came on. McFadden it is, trying to give Burke his first touch, but free kick goes against James McFadden, who kicks the ball away. Has the referee seen that? If he has, McFadden will almost certainly be booked here. And how daft is that?
James McFadden thought he isn't all over, but I said before, he can take that part of his game. He has to cut that. That's just a silly booking there. But I think at times with James, he's deceptive. He has actually played against him on a number of occasions. He's very, very strong on the ball. And but Walter, I'm sure Walter Smith will be happy with that. That yellow card is picked up.
Well, James McFadden, a goal and a booking since coming on, but he's had a really good positive impact on the second half. Can Scotland protect this two-goal cushion? Fletcher, Caldwell, themselves out of trouble, but Bulgaria pick up once again. Caldwell again, strong play from Caldwell in the tackle, and a chance for McCulloch to come forward here. The support on the left from Naismith. Naismith in no hurry. Ray to McCulloch. Anderson involved, and Naismith. Good football once again from Scotland. Can Lee McCulloch deliver a good cross? No, he's not in any hurry. Naismith. Fletcher's return. Smith's delivery, chance for Burke. Oh, fantastic from Chris Burke. Well, I reckon that's near enough his first touch, and that's absolutely sensational football from Scotland, and a sensational finish from Chris Burke. Well, just like his Rangers teammate Chris Boyd, he scored on his Scotland debut, and maybe in the rest of his life he might not score a better goal. He certainly won't get a more memorable goal than that. Chris Burke puts Scotland 4-1 ahead in Kobe. Quite extraordinary.
Great ball in from Fletcher, and again, this is a great ball across crossfield from Naismith. What a fantastic finish from Chris. Well, that's absolutely brilliant. You can see what he's doing all day long. Just but for me, before that, kind of thing, the build-up play, the possession, you can see the boys, you know, not very often Scotland are 3-1 up, and this confidence is oozing out the guys, and you know, all, even Russell Anderson at the back was getting involved in the possession play and the build-up of it all. And deservedly so, Scotland be the better side tonight, and the 4-1 up was great.
Well, Scotland are heading now for a famous victory. Of course, Bulgaria will claim that most, if not all, of their top players aren't available. Well, the same can be said for Scotland. And that scoreline, if Bulgaria won, Scotland 4, will create a few shockwaves around the world, certainly around Europe, as Bulgaria come forward once again. Well, if they are going to draw inspiration, it will be from that man, Martin Petrov, their captain, but that was a bit wild. And as we watch this rerun from him, there's going to be another Scotland substitution. On will come Ian Murray. Murray coming on for his fifth cap. And Lee McCulloch has played his final part in this match. He's done well, Lee McCulloch. And on trots Ian Murray.
Yeah, I think it's Lee McCulloch done a marvellous job. See Walter Smith just below us congratulating him there for his performance, his effort tonight. I think from everyone right through the side, the effort's been marvellous. Walter will be delighted. He's not been kidded by this. This is...